All right. Now, the endpoint stuff on this side, endpoint is independent of your security infrastructure and then can be performed on almost any network, right? You just connect to the machine and analyze whatever's on the endpoint. Data-driven, your environment needs to be configured to make this possible. Your environment needs to be configured to make this work well for you. You're going to find that you really need to do a good job organizing and architecting your network with enabling log forwarding on all endpoints that you want to monitor so that you forward all the logs to your aggregate log server or Splunk server. You're also going to have to strictly enforce network time protocol to really make this work, because you don't want to make your life worse by not having centralized time. This becomes a real big pain in the butt if you've got multiple locations that are geographically dispersed in different time zones. Then NTP using UTC becomes extremely, extremely important. What is threat hunting, right? Okay, it's the path that the attacker takes to the compromise. It's the steps in the process, the recon, the exploitation, the lateral movement to exploitation, all of that is the kill chain. So the reason that people like to do these kill chain things is it helps non-technical, less technical people understand the steps that an attacker is taking in your environment, right? They like seeing from recon to exploitation to stealing data. They like seeing how the attacker moves through this kill chain, okay? It's just a way for people to explain to non-technical people what's going on. Instead of waiting for something to tell me that there's been a compromise in my environment, basically threat hunting is I'm going out there and I'm looking for it. So the beauty that you're going to gain with Splunk is you've got an ecosystem of tools and capabilities that allow you to really, really get knee-deep in data analysis. So you've got the ad hoc search stuff. This is what we're doing here. Now, the overwhelming majority of this class is going to be on this. Everything that I'm going to be showing you with Splunk is going to be designed for somebody who's using Splunk in a small environment at a fairly low cost and didn't buy all the enterprise cool toys that connect onto it. So you're going to see that I'm using the free implementation of Splunk for this course, and everything is going to be me teaching you how to write queries for this environment. That is what I'm going to be doing. I'm going to teach you what hackers do, and I'm going to teach you how to write queries to look for what hackers do. That's why we're going to stay focused for this class over here. The bulk of what I'm going to be teaching is going to be how to write queries. I will show you how to pull in data from other sources. I will show you how to do things like import PCAPs into Splunk. I will show you how to do things like import IOCs into Splunk. Again, I'm going to show you that kind of stuff. But the thought process of this class is you are a guy who's a security guy, and they stuck you with Splunk and didn't teach you how to use the doggone thing.